pongo más. Pronto llegará el día de mi suerte. Te lo juro por mi gente. Te juro que un día llegará. And we won't stop. We always do. We make it. Even though you play it, we still make it. Welcome to Nordic Drip Coaching. My camera overheats all the time, guys. Do not get you guys no Sony V1, Z1, whatever it is. It is already on overheat mode. Like, I'm so done with it. Today is Puerto Rican Parade. Yesterday was the festival in Harlem. I just love Summer Jam. But as far as from what I've seen from the lineup, the last 2 years has sucked. Like, the lineup to me is just so corny. I'm just like, nah, I'm not about to pay money to go see no corny ass artist. Today is the Puerto Rican Parade. So I'm not going just because I don't want to be around a crowd of people, per usual. Introvert life. As you guys heard, I had to play a little bit of Big Pun. Big Pun, I swear, he is one of the best rappers along with Biggie. So it just brings like Puerto Rican vibes, Bronx vibes, Bronx represent. And in New York City, guys, everyone has the flags on their car. Everybody's representing for Puerto Rico. I'm not gonna even lie, Puerto Rico was beautiful. I enjoyed being in Puerto Rico. So I'm definitely gonna make another trip. I just think it's a beautiful island to visit. The food? You think you have real Puerto Rican food here? You think you have real acapulco? You think you have real chicken, rice, and beans? You think you have real carne guisao? What? And carne guisao, guys, is like a beef stew. Listen, Puerto Rico definitely has the best food. I'm definitely gonna go back. And my kids are like, Mom, we gotta go back to Puerto Rico. We gotta go back. So that is in the cards for us to do. I love traveling. I wish I had this channel a couple of years back. You would have seen our Spain trip. My son posted a vlog. His vlog is right here. Check it out. It's our trip to Spain. It's a beautiful day as of now. Earlier, it was raining, but right now, it's just a beautiful day. I went to the gym earlier. I got me a Henny Colada from Apollo. You guys already know. Guys, quick question. Do you guys have a partner that just loves to stare at you all day? Yeah. My partner, like right now, he's standing outside the car, but he loves looking at me when I vlog. It is so annoying because I hate when people look at me when I'm in front of the camera. He just loves to look at me vlog. I'm just like, if you want to see me, just watch my content, clearly. So yeah, so that's what's going on now. The Bronx is always home to me. I moved out the Bronx years ago. The Bronx will always be home. The Bronx will always be in my DNA. The Bronx, I will always rep the Bronx. BK for me, it just hits different. As of lately, I've been really enjoying. Before, I used to hate to come to Brooklyn. My spouse is from Brooklyn, and I used to hate to drive to Brooklyn. I definitely do not mind being driven to Brooklyn. The fact that he drives me here is so much more better, but I hate driving to Brooklyn. I just like when I'm in Brooklyn already. So if I could snap my fingers and be in Brooklyn, that would be a great thing. So I'll definitely show you guys around, guys. Bye. So I wanted to show you guys my outfit today. I don't have a long mirror in my house. I have on bell bottoms, guys. And they're really cute. I really like them. And this is my outfit. Hold on, wait. Here, yeah, you can see them better here. Hold on. So you see? You see the bottom? Yeah. Question, guys. He says that you can eat these berries. I'm not gonna eat it. Would you? He's gonna have one. Are you gonna eat it?
I'm not eating nothing. I'm gonna go for an apple or pear before I eat that.
One thing I love is a good farmer's market.
And we started this farm, our farm, because we used to be migrant workers. I remember when we were young kids, we would travel back to Texas, back to New York, and actually my parents were working for a farm that's actually like doesn't exist no more for 25 years. That was our life.
Yeah.
No other thing. We didn't know, no other job actually. I was working there as a teenager, and I met my husband there.
Okay.
And my husband's like, what do we do now?
Mm-hmm.
So he came up with the idea. He did a small farm stand.
Mm-hmm.
And then he has a friend that works for Grow NYC that is also a farmer. And he was like, hey, okay, if you're already doing it on a small scale, why don't you improve and do it in a bigger scale?
Exactly.
And ever since then, it's been expanding and expanding, and we've been doing this 11 years strong.
Awesome. So can you just tell people why we need farmers markets, why we should support farms more?
Well, like us, we're just small. It's us, my husband, us, and the kids that run it.
Okay.
And, you know, just eat healthier.
Yes.
You know, a lot of us eat, even including us.
Yes, sometimes we have our days.
Yes, you know, we're working from 5 to 9, and, you know, we don't eat sometimes dinner time. And what do when we're out in the field all day? Just go grab something quick to eat, you know, that's not the healthy way.
No,
It definitely is not the healthy way, you know. Also, the product lasts longer.
Yes, organic does last a lot longer.
The taste is different than, you know.
Definitely is the taste.
A tomato from the grocery store, you can pick it up and smell it, and once you slice it, it's dry from the inside.
Yeah.
You know, when you're getting a fresh tomato from the farmer's market.
And, like, there's no seeds. And when it's organic, you see seeds.
Juice
coming out of it. Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm so happy that you got to explain a little bit about your farmer's market, which is amazing. And just thank you for just, you know, giving us feedback.
Thank you.
Johnny Brown on us.
Oh, thank you so much.
Just the end of the day.
I'll take the sesame. Oh, that looks really good. So I'm getting free sesame bread today, guys. Yeah, so this one looks amazing. So I'm gonna get this one.
What time do you have?
And I bought cilantro, lettuces. While we support the farmer's market, guys, he got me a margarita. Yeah, so we got the margarita. I got my bread, my cilantro. This bench was made for us. Look at what it says, guys. Pizza liquor. Definitely me. Pizza liquor. It's such a beautiful day, guys. And this is what makes me happy. Just being outdoors, enjoying life, seeing other people enjoy life. Yeah. Good vibes, guys. Good vibes only. Check out this amazing bread, guys. This is bread. Bread by the water, looking over the city. Days like this, can't get no better. So this is a vintage clothing store. We're gonna go inside. So we are at a vintage store in Brooklyn. Would you like to just explain a little bit about your store?
Hey, I have Velma Vintage. I carry a lot of workwear as well as mixed with circus, basically. I've been calling it rainbow grunge.
Okay, I like it.
No, there'll be another 10 different names for it by the time I'm done with it. But it's a lot of vintage workwear mixed with the circus. And I'm located in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, tucked away in a nice little loft building.
It's such a cute shop, guys. Literally, it's such a cool vibe. And I'm getting this, actually, because this is really Japan vibes.
It is.
If you can just
Japan
show them
vibes.
That, I'm going to get this. Because my goal is to go to Japan one day, so I have to start dressing like I'm already in Japan.
It's 1950s.
Okay.
Kimono.
I love it.
Yeah, silk. It's a summer kimono. They're called yukatas.
I love it.
Generally, I get to go once a year. I know. That's why I know it's 1950s. Just and I do have to also add another note, since last month I did roll around to my 13th year in business.
Congratulations.
So I've been doing this for 13 years. So I love your pants.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah,
so I haven't had the bell bottoms on, guys.
You should see these
bell
bottom pants.
Yes, you guys gotta see these. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But yeah, thank you so much.
Mm-hmm. Hey, thank you.
And I will leave her store down below, and I will leave the link so you guys can come here. You guys will not be disappointed.
guys, we are at a place called Radegast. It's actually serving German food. My spouse has never had German food, right?
Big for anything.
Yeah, so he's ready for anything. German food is a little bit like Scandinavian, so they have a lot of sausages and things like that. So we're here and I'm excited to show you guys what we're gonna eat. And this place is called Radegast and it's in Williamsburg, Brooklyn.
So we're gonna probably have a rabbit burger. He says he is gonna tear it off. I'm saying he's crazy. I'm gonna get the lamb chop.
Rabbit meat pool.
Yeah, but you don't see
in
no,
a dinner entry.
Yeah, but you don't see no burger saying that.
Oh no, not burger. Just say rabbit.
No, it says rabbit meat pool. I don't want no rabbit meat pool.
Just living our best lives.